hosting parties for the events, and our royal supporters and our gala supporters. Our royal supporters for the evening tonight were Pepsi Beverage. I don't believe there's anybody here from Pepsi to accept the award, but Piedmont Mountainside Hospital is also a royal supporter, and I believe Dr. Sonny Proctor is here to accept the award on their behalf. Scratch that, it's Mary Doyle. As we recognize our hosting parties for this evening, first of all, we'd like to recognize the Georgia Mountains Hospice Board of Directors that are here. Let's call Ms. Betty Francis, wherever you are, please stand up. Judge Brenda Weaver. Ms. Maureen Lindsay. And Mr. Jim Jackson. Who would give them a round of applause? Representing the LJ Council of the Knights of Columbus, Mr. Clay Keel. And representing the Jasper Council of Knights of Columbus, Mr. Martin Rapp. Representing the Rotary Club of Jasper, President Kay Lawrence. At this time, it's my honor and privilege to introduce to you the Executive Director of Georgia Mountain Hospice and the person without whom this program would not get put together. I'd like to call up for our presentation Ms. Gina Pendley.
It wouldn't be possible without volunteers and this Georgia Mountains Hospice staff and Board of Directors and the Knights of Columbus and the Rotary to join in. Wait. Yeah, sorry. I've got more to say. I told somebody the other day the quickest way I know to stop a conversation is to tell them you work for hospice because nobody knows what to say. I appreciate you being here. I want everybody to feel good about being here, spending money. One of the programs that we do at Georgia Mountains Hospice is funded by this money is our Wishes and Dreams program. I want to show you a little video. It's just about 3 or 4 minutes. Just to show you why we do what we do. Okay, now. This is a patient of ours that was in Union County Nursing Home. His sister was in Gilmer Nursing Home. They hadn't seen each other for 3 years, so we paid for an ambulance to take her to visit her brother. This man just wanted to play in his bluegrass band one more time. So we bought food and got them together and they played in his trailer. This little girl was 10 years old. She wanted a swimming pool, so we helped pay for a pool. Not a lot of money. Amber was 24 years old. She lived in Canton. She was a school teacher. Her husband wanted to do something for their 4th anniversary. So we bought them dinner at the Woodbridge. Bought them flowers. Linda wanted to go fishing, you can see. We just fixed her car, $150. Very little. This little girl lived in LJ. She wanted to be princess for a day. So we bought netting and her teachers dressed up and she was princess. This man lived in Union County Nursing Home. He wanted a TV and all the Westerns. His roommate was probably more excited than he was. James just wanted to be able to take his dog out. We helped his family pay for the motorized wheelchair. We didn't pay for all of it. Kenny lived in Dawsonville. He wanted to go to the Georgia Tech game. So we brought, along with Ed Singleton from Subway, helped us buy tickets. Kenny took his mother and his brother and his 12-year-old girlfriend. Mary wanted to read her books again. She was in Chatsworth Nursing Home. So we bought a magnified light, a lamp. Malin hadn't seen his daughter for 8 years. She lived in California, so we bought a plane ticket and she visited him for a week. Kathy wanted to make quilts for all of her grandchildren. We bought the fabric. It was a couple hundred dollars. That's why we do what we do. I don't want it to be sad. I don't want anybody to feel sorry for these patients and their families. They got exactly what they wanted. We were able to fill their wish and dream. But I want you to know why you're here. I want you to go. I want you to go to the silent auction. I want you to bid on these gifts and feel good about the money that you're spending here tonight. It doesn't take much to fill these people's wishes and dreams. Thank you.
The first thing we'd like to do is to introduce to you the 2016 reigning queen of the Mardi Gras on the Mountain, Ms. Sidney Mahan, and the reigning king, Mr. Jack Mahan. They have been a terrific couple, served their community well over the past year, and we thank them for the job that they have done. I will also say that according to the bylaws of Mardi Gras on the Mountain, Ms. Sidney, this is the last night that you are allowed to wear the crown.
Thank you.
There may be a vote after this, I'm not sure. To start off with our nominees for the 2017 King and Queen, I'd first like to introduce the Cherokee County Queen nominee, Dale Scarlett Morrissey. A great deal of her free time working with organizations that she finds near and dear to her. She's thrilled to be serving Georgia Mountain Hospice in this role and knows firsthand, after caring for an elderly parent, what an important role hospice plays. Dale's a Pickens County native. She graduated from Pickens High School and then attended Reynolds College, where she earned her degree in business administration. Dale and her husband coach, Tom Marcy, found a new home in Clovis, California, where she continued a banking career. But then the Morrissey family, including now groom children Noah, Nicole, and Nick, moved back to Georgia and settled in Cherokee County. Dale now serves as the Director of Development and External Relations at Reinhardt University. While her career has taken a different path, her service remains the same. She supports a day for Reinhardt and has for more than 10 years served as the committee chair in 2015. In her professional role, she spearheads projects throughout the year for Reinhardt University. She's served as president of the Alumni Board of Governors from 2005 to 2007 and currently serves on the board of the Sheriff's Foundation. She has strong ties to the Chamber of Commerce in Cherokee County, where she has served on numerous committees and has served as chairman of the board in 2008. She's currently a member of the Chairman's Council for the Cherokee Chamber. Ladies and gentlemen, the Queen nominee from Cherokee County, Dale Scarlett. The King nominee from Cherokee County is Frank Reynolds. He's been a Cherokee resident for 8 years and was recently elected in 2016 to serve as the sheriff of Cherokee County.
Yeah.
He's married to the beautiful daughter Jennifer DeBorn Reynolds, and they have 3 children. Frank and his family are very active at Waleska Baptist Church, and he attended Reinhardt University, receiving degrees from there and later a master's degree from Georgia's Law Enforcement Command College at Columbia State University in public administration. After serving in Iraq as an operational security specialist and tactical commander, he's also spent years in law enforcement, holding both management and leadership roles, preparing him for the office he holds today. Frank holds professional instructor certificates, and some of his specialized instructor training and training certifications include drug recognition expert, advanced marksman, and master SWAT. He He's an active member of the community through the Rotary Club of Canton, the Optimist Club of Canton, the Cherokee Chamber of Commerce, and the Cherokee Historical Society. His many awards include the Bryant Park University 10 Under 10 Annual Award, a Medal of Bravery, and a Meritorious Service Award. Ladies and gentlemen, Sheriff Frank Reynolds, the King County United Cherokee. The Dawson County Queen nominee is Sue Wells. Born originally in Clemson, South Carolina, but spending the majority of her childhood in Hawaii, after graduating from Orlando, Florida, she's pursued a degree at North Carolina and at Florida State. She has many successful careers at college, including dental hygienist and flight attendant for Delta Airlines for more than 17 years. She's currently a real estate agent with Keeler Williams Community Partners. She met her husband, Randy, a Delta Airlines pilot, while serving together, flying to Buffalo, New York. They've been married for 21 years, and as they say, the rest is history. They have one child, Cameron, who's a senior at Lakeview Academy. Believing in being involved with her son in the local community, Sue has served as the advancement chairman for Boy Scout Troop 3740 and is a member of the Dawson County Chamber of Commerce. 5 years ago, she and her neighbor started a Thanksgiving turkey drive for the Rick Rack, the Dawson County Food Bank. The food bank has expanded every year and made this partnership with the Rotary Club of Dawson County. Sue said she lost her father 6 years ago, and her family leaned on hospice care in Deland, Florida. To us, it was an agonizing time, but their compassion helped my father pass away comfortably and with dignity. It is her honor to serve in this role for Georgia Mountain Hospice. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Sue Wells. Joining her on the dais is her husband, the Dawson County Key nominee, Randy Wells. He was born on an Air Force base in New Jersey as the son of an Air Force pilot. He has moved numerous times and graduated from high school in Pennsylvania, where he earned a degree in business administration. He has been a member of cross-country teams, ROTC teams, and after college, he went into the Air Force, flying a C-141B at McGuire Air Force Base, the same aircraft his dad had flown 10 years earlier. In 1990, he started serving Delta Airlines, where he is currently an international first officer, flying 767-400s. In addition to flying, he's a real estate agent at Keeler Williams Community Partner. And again, he met his lovely wife 21 years ago on a flight to Buffalo, New York. They have one son, Cameron, and he's at Lakeview Academy. He's been an assistant scoutmaster at Boy Scout Troop 3740 and is currently a member of the Dawson County Chamber. When asked about this role, he said, "I am pleased and happy to have this opportunity to serve Georgia Mountain Hospice." Ladies and gentlemen, the Dawson County King nominee, Mr. Randy Wells. Representing Gilmer County as the Queen nominee is Heather Chastain Simmons. She is a Gilmer County native, born at Edward Beverly Chastain. She's a 1994 graduate of Gilmer High School, and her education includes a background in computer with a degree from Appalachian Technical College and from Dalton State College. Heather has a diploma from New York Institute of Photography, which supports her photography habit. In December of 2012, she married Brad Simmons, also a Gilmer County native, in what sounds to be an awesome Vegas-style wedding, including an Elvis with her family and friends present for the occasion. Heather and Brad became the owners of River Street Tavern in May of 2014, and in May of 2016, they added another restaurant to their family when they purchased the 1907 Lee's on River Street with Brad's mother, Kathy Simmons Taylor, and stepfather, Howard Taylor. Heather and Brad have no children, but they have two fur babies, Tyler and Lola. Yay. Ladies and gentlemen, Heather Simmons, the Queen nominee from Gilmer County. The Gilmer County Queen nominee is Brad Simmons, a Gilmer County native. Brad graduated in 2001 from Gilmer High School and has been a firefighter EMT for 13 years. Again, in December of 2012, he married Heather Chastain, another Gilmer native. They owned the River Street Tavern and have purchased the 1907 Lee's in River Street. Ladies and gentlemen, the Gilmer nominee, Brad Simmons. Representing Pickens County as the Queen nominee is Amy Fountain Leake. Amy is honored to serve this role for Georgia Mountain Hospice, which she considers to be wonderful and necessary service to the community. She's proud to be a lifelong resident of Pickens County, and her roots run very deep here, going back many generations. After high school, she attended Chattahoochee Technical College, where she studied cosmetology and was Pickens Tech's star student the year she graduated. After 20 years in the industry, she was given an opportunity to buy her grandmother's former home in the heart of downtown Jasper. She's transformed that home into a thriving business known as Salon 84. The company's success and their willingness to give back in the community didn't go unnoticed, and she's been awarded the Small Business of the Month in September of 2015 and Small Business of the Year for 2015 by the Pickens County Chamber of Commerce. She and her staff have hosted fundraisers throughout the years for the Mardi Gras King and Queen. She and her company take it seriously that they make a difference in this community. Amy served 3 years on the Pickens County Chamber Board of Directors and is currently the chair of the Downtown Alliance Committee. She also serves on the Strategic Planning Committee for the Pickens County Board of Education. She's a member of Antioch Baptist Church and is married to Sergeant Chris Leake, who's a 15-year veteran with the Pickens Sheriff's Office. They have three wonderful children, Jackson, Madison, and Brody. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pickens nominee for Queen, Amy Fountain Leake. Last, but certainly not least, King nominee, Mr. Lonnie Waters. Lonnie Waters became a volunteer with the 4-H in Pickens County in 1994 and has volunteered for 22 years straight. He's an alumni of Georgia 4-H where he competed in livestock and public speaking. He's currently the SAFE, which is the shotgun team head coach, and actively supports the program throughout the year, coordinating fundraisers to support the young people. He was also elected as an outstanding lifetime volunteer by the district, Northeast District, Georgia 4-H in 2015. He is the Utilities, Development, Permits, Annexation, and Mapping Director, as well as Animal Control and City Event Coordinator for the City of Jasper. Lonnie's worked for 21 years as a funeral director and served 8 years as the elected coroner of Pickens County. He's been on the board of directors for the Chamber of Commerce, Hazard Mitigation and Emergency Management, and has had multiple duties with the City of Jasper, serving the community. In addition, he finds time to spend time with his lovely wife, Ruth Ann, 15 years, their three sons, and three grandchildren. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Lonnie Waters of the Pickens County. What a tremendous opportunity it is for these folks to represent Georgia Mountain Hospice in the fundraising effort. It's always interesting when I get to open the envelope to see how much money was raised by the individuals on this stage. This year's amount was $15,829.65 that goes to make wishes and dreams come true. I'm pleased to present to you for the first time the 2017 King and Queen of the Mardi Gras in the Mountains, Miss Amy Fountain Leake and Lonnie Waters. We'd like to welcome to the stage Allison, Boyle, and Keith Petty. Tonight, they'll perform The Prayer, made famous by Celine Dion.
speranza, unione di alla Manuel sovricino, simbolo di pace, di fraternità. La forza che ci dà.
Again, it is a privilege and an honor to welcome to the dance floor for the first time, as royalty, King Lonnie Waters and Queen Amy Fountain Leake.
So cute.
We will share the first dance with the royal court, who will join in shortly.
Yeah.